G'day, it's Peter from Total Bathrooms, and today I'm bringing you another episode of Total Answers, this time a little bit more in depth. So I've got a presentation for you, and today's topic is space-saving ideas in bathroom design, a really important one. So I hope you'll enjoy it. So there are a number of things to consider when wanting to design a small space. And the first and most important thing that I've got on my list is color. It needs to be light and bright. Now, white is best, but other soft neutral colors such as soft grays and seafoam greens will work just as well. And you can see a couple of examples here. And of course, white can be a bit boring, so it's nice to mix in some of these other colors. The second thing is wall coverings. Really important to have wall coverings. Large format tiles give the illusion of more space. And if you can have some sort of gloss effect on them, that reflects light and in turn gives the feeling of more space. And if you have a texture as well, that can give you a feeling of space as well and draw the eye to that texture and away from the size of the room. Backlit panels with scenes on them give a great illusion of space. You can see one here in a bamboo forest, but equally you don't have to have them backlit. Just a beautiful glass printed panel or other material can give you the feeling that the room extends on into that scene. Number three, floor coverings. Okay, again here, large format tiles are really good. They give the illusion of more space and the gloss again can reflect the light, but you do have to think about non-slip. Of course, gloss tiles can be a little bit more slippery, so check out the slip resistance before you go ahead and order. And of course, lighter pattern stone colored tiles are better than dark. So patterns, stones, all those kind of finishes on tiles, if you lighten the color, you get the feeling of more space, but it doesn't preclude you from having patterns or stone, as you can see in these photographs here. Long, thin tiles, particularly like the wood effect ones in the bottom left-hand corner here. If you've got long, thin tiles, lay them so that they run vertically away from the door towards the length of the room. That gives the feeling of more space as well. And you can see in the top right there, the shower tray can be tiled so that the floor looks seamless. If instead of having, say, a standard white tray in the room, you can afford to tile the tray, then you do give the feeling that the floor extends on into the shower, and that in turn gives the feeling of more space. Number four, mirrors. This is probably the most important thing because it's the easiest thing you can do, and you can even do it in a room that exists that you're not redesigning, that you just want to create a bit more space. So you can have full wall mirrors, as you can see in the left-hand picture here. You can put a mirror over the basin. You can have more than one mirror. You can have a mirror over the basin and then a mirror behind or offset so that that gives reflection upon reflection and increases the space, particularly if you've got some natural light, which we'll come to later on. And you can see in the right there, you can use decorative mirrors around the room. These are decorative mirrored tiles that create a magnificent, I think you'll agree, walled effect that fits in nicely with the look in the bathroom on the right. Number five, clever lighting. Now, I've got a couple of pages of this because lighting is so important. The first one is about natural light. Natural light is absolutely brilliant to make space. So whatever windows you've got, try to open them up, give as much light as you possibly can. Put in a Velux or a skylight if you haven't already got one in the room. And you'll notice here in the middle, there's a really small photograph of a skylight. These are very clever. If you don't have any external walls, or even if you do, and you want to create more light, you can get these skylights that use lined tubes that bounce the light from that little roof tile all the way down and into the room, and of course give you natural light even where you don't have walls with windows on them. So, and you can see here how much brighter and lighter these smaller rooms look by the use of natural light. Clever lighting. Number two, use lit recesses and accent lighting to help enlarge the space, and this also creates a positive mood. You can see in the left picture here, you've got a recess that's lit, looking very sexy. The wall is lit as well, but we'll come to that in the next slide. And in the middle here, you can see two really beautifully illuminated recesses. And on the right-hand side, you can see some accent lighting and how that really lifts the mood of that room and makes a very narrow room look bigger. Clever lighting number three, backlit walls and feature walls. So you saw on the last page, there was a backlit wall. You can see in the top right here, a backlit wall that's being viewed through a big mirror. Of course, that's using some of these effects together. If you put all these things I'm teaching you together, you're going to make the small space seem as big as it absolutely can. The other thing I love is backlit walls, which we alluded to in the first slide when we were talking about wall coverings. In the bottom right here, you can see onyx, which is a natural stone, a slither of onyx, which is backlit by lights. Now, that's a very expensive way to go because stone like that is very expensive, but it's a magnificent and space-creating look. And on the left here, we get back to the backlit scene. Here's another one, a lovely lagoon photo that gives the idea that that shower is effectively poised on the beach. Okay, so number six, make the most of the architecture. You can see here quite a few examples of using sloping ceilings, vaults, voids, and any unused spaces to fit clever and efficient features. The first one to the bottom left is an understairs cloakroom. Many of you will be familiar with this type of thing. There's a lot of, if you use some of these other tips that I'm giving you, you can make an understairs cloakroom in the smallest of spaces functional and look bigger than it actually is. You can create seats in that second photo with storage underneath them. You can see how they've used the lack of headspace to create a seat or a bench to lie in the shower, but also a lovely space for large items that perhaps in a flat, a top floor flat, you wouldn't have room for. Then up to the top there in the middle, there's two built recesses. We talked about lighting those recesses. Actually building them creates space because you can put your bits and pieces in them, sometimes for show, sometimes just for use. And that cleans up the surfaces around the bathroom, and that in turn makes the bathroom look bigger. You can use a pocket door. You see that in the top right there. Pocket doors are awesome. You can't always use them. It depends on the structure of the wall, and you might have to rebuild the wall, but they save so much space because you don't have to allow for the opening and the closing of the door hitting something in the room. And then the bottom there, you can see how you can use the windowsill to put things like accoutrements or mirrors or sometimes flush plates. In my bathroom, I've got a flush plate sitting in the windowsill on the horizontal. And you can also see there that the toilet cistern is hidden cleverly into a shelf. But indeed, later we'll see you can hide them in the wall as well. So make the most of the architecture, use your corners. This right picture is actually a display in our showroom. I'm not a massive fan of corner loos or basins. They have their place, and there are certain spaces which are excellent that they make up the space. But I prefer not to have the corner basin and particularly toilet if possible. And instead you can see here how we've used a small space in a display, but in your bedroom, you can imagine this, to create a lovely ensuite in a corner, effectively, with a pentagra tiled shower tray and shower door. Okay, now we get onto clever space-saving products. These are fun because there's so many things that we do these days that save space. You can see the first one at the top there is a cupboard built into the wall. Now, it looks like a mirror with a frame around it, and there are steel versions of this. They don't have to have wood frames like this one does. But when you pull the mirror open, you reveal that actually there's a cupboard built into the wall. Of course, this means you can hide your accoutrements, your bits and bobs away, and people won't necessarily know that they're there. I've got something similar to this in my own house. And then you can see just beside it, a toilet and basin in one. Now there's many different versions of this. I won't go into the details because there are different ways that these work. However, this is a great way to get a very small cloakroom space where you don't have enough width to fit a basin and a toilet. You can get two in one. And of course it's environmentally friendly because the gray water runs down into the cistern to be used in the next flush. You can see on the bottom right there that wall-hung toilets, this is really important. Wall-hung makes the space look bigger. That's units as well, not just toilets, because you can see, your eye can see more of the floor space, and that creates the feeling of more space. You can even get frames and cisterns that fit inside a standard wall. So 80 millimeters or 8 centimeters thick, which will fit inside a standard 100 mil stud wall. So that is a brilliant, that's been around for a while actually, but that is a brilliant invention. And then you can disguise floor drains because of course, if you make the floor seem like one big continuous run of tiles, for example, or other floor covering, you'll make the room look bigger. And you can see here, we've got two different types of drains, one slightly obscured by my picture, but you can see that the wall covering one is the most space saving of all because the water actually runs down and into the gully in the wall. And that is accessible through that little plate. So it's not like you can never get to it again. Space, clever space saving products, page two. You can see there that we've got all sorts of space-saving furniture. I've just put one there where the toilet is in a very slimline cistern concealed box, and the basin is incorporated in the same unit, and that gets it within a meter space. You can have a basin and a toilet together quite efficiently and with plenty of space for both needs. And then on the right hand side, you can see slimline cabinets. Now, this is probably the most popular thing that you can do in your house as it exists. You don't have to change the bathroom at all. You can just put in a nice slimline cupboard over the basin rather than perhaps a mirror that you've got there already. You can fit tons of stuff, but it doesn't protrude very far off the wall, so therefore doesn't waste space and make you feel like you're going to hit your head every time you go down to wash your face or shave or whatever it is that you do. You can see to the bottom left, there's shelves that can be placed over the very simple solution over the top of a toilet to use that dead space. You can see heated towel rails doubling as shelves. And guys, there are heaps and heaps of different types of products that we can offer in this area. I'm just giving you a few. The folding shower seat is another one, which is great for not just people that have trouble with the standing up. It's also great when you want to wash your feet, when you just want to relax, potentially under a nice deluge shower. A folding seat is a great way to have a seat, but then when you don't need it, it folds up and it's well out of the way. And then number eight, create a theme and or a focal point that can help distract the eye and make the brain focus on something else, make the room feel bigger. You can see in the bottom left, one of my favorite features is a moss wall or having lush plants in the bathroom. This is both visually appealing, but also very healthy because it scrubs the air and keeps the air fresher and cleaner in the bathroom as the plants use the stale parts of the air for their rejuvenation. You could try a theme. You can see in the middle here, there's a kind of a sea theme, but doesn't have to be that. It can be any sort of theme. It just makes the brain, it distracts the brain from the actual space, and it gets the brain thinking about the theme. And then on the far right here, you can have a freestanding bath or something else as a wow factor. Could be a big lush mirror and unit that fills just one wall that draws the eye. Could be a magnificent plant, could be a one of those walls we talked about earlier on. But one of the things I like about this bottom right picture is actually that it incorporates a shower and a bath in a very clever wet area in what is probably far too thin a room to fit them conventionally. You can see that any water spillage that comes out of that bath will run down into the shower drain. And if you wanted to have a bath, you can just walk through the shower cubicle very comfortably and get into the bath. So it's a really clever way, this design. My sister in Australia is actually has designed a similar space to this, or had me help her with the design. So great way, guys, to fit in a freestanding bath and a shower into a very small, what otherwise would be too small a room. And finally, and this is the most important one, and I know you saw it coming, but get an expert to help you, because there are so many pitfalls that people like us who have been in the game for 21 years know about that you wouldn't. What goes with what? You know, what will work with your drainage? What about your plumbing system? You know, all these different questions. And we can help with that. And we offer free home visits where we can measure, plan, and advise, as well as in-store appointments. So here's one we made earlier. Great vaulted ceiling in the basement of a house in Bath. Magnificent project, really tricky to get to, down lots of flights of stairs, very tight. The fitter spent a lot longer than would normally be taken in a room of this size, just simply because of the access issues. And you can see how using the large format tiles, brighter colors, better lighting makes a huge difference. Facing the other way in this room, you can see small grout lines in the left-hand side, lots of little tiles, cluttered. Now have a look on the right, what it looks like now. So much tidier, so much more spacious. And that's even using a dark colored unit, which the customer chose. One could have even brightened it more if you wanted to. But I think you'll agree that's a huge improvement. And just finally to let you know, look, we've got a team of 18 staff in our place in Bath, three departments, and they're all very friendly and helpful. Nine of them are designers and are there to basically meet with you and do designs, meet with you as many times as you need to make sure you get the kind of bathroom that you dreamed about and that you, the most that you can get for your money, really. You can refer to us with confidence because we've been doing this for 21 years and we've got some very nice reviews, which we'd encourage you to read on Google. So, you know, they're not things that we can manipulate. And yeah, it's really hard won. And we like to think that we give the best service of any bathroom company in the area. And we're very large with 60 displays as well. We offer lots of different services, which you can read for yourself there. Particularly, I think the thing that's of most interest to people is the in-showroom appointments where you can look around the displays. Just book those in advance. At the moment, you're welcome to come down and have a look around. And if you want designs, though, do book. And if you'd like us to visit your home to measure up, then also please do book. We'd be happy to do that for you. And basically, that is the end. So I hope you've enjoyed that. This was about designing small spaces. Hope I've given you some ideas for your own bathroom, maybe made you into a designer of your own rooms. And if you need any help at all, you know where to find us. Total Bathrooms on the Brass Mill Lane Trading Estate, Bath. I've been Peter. Thanks for watching. Hopefully one day you'll let us transform your day by transforming your bathroom.